Welcome to the Holy Land. How's it going?
My name is Joe Riley. I'm a lieutenant in the U.S. Army. I'm an infantry officer.
My name is Steve Rabin. I am a speechwriter, and I live in Washington, D.C.
My name is Krishanti Vignaraja. I work as senior advisor to the Deputy Secretary of State.
I'm Travis Mason. I'm from Washington, D.C. I'm really excited to be here.
Tel Aviv is the second largest city in Israel, about 410,000 residents. And this is actually the economic engine of the country. And we'll talk more about that tomorrow when we do a little tour of Tel Aviv.
We work with young people. We want to know what your dreams are. We want to understand where it is you want to go. We want to help you achieve your objectives. We look forward to giving you the best possible experience we can to understand Israel through your own eyes, through their own experiences.
Israel is, you know, one of America's strongest allies and has been a major player in our policy in the Middle East. So getting to come and have a first-hand experience of Israeli life and politics and security issues was very important to me.
As a Jew, I think it's just so important to try to come to Israel as often as possible to create a connection with Israel and start to build that relationship with the country, with its people.
Being Jewish is a critical part in the way I think of my leadership. And so I always think about any endeavor that I want to take on is how do I make the world better off than when I found it.
It's also really a different perspective to get to talk with people who are influential leaders in the Israeli society. I think that that's a really unique aspect of this trip that I'm very excited about.
Count how many achievements did you have in your lives and how many dreams you have in your mind. If you'll find that you have more dreams than achievements, you are young. If you think you have more achievements than dreams, you're old. So keep dreaming and keep acting.
Being here is about learning. It's about asking questions. It's about seeing. And so traveling to Israel is a unique opportunity and one that I'm, you know, very grateful that even though it's vacation time, it's probably the best use of this time.
This is the Gaza Strip.
So one of the things we heard was about how close you are to Gaza. Why do you want to stay? Why don't you move?
Okay, זה הבית שלי. אני אוהב את המקום הזה. מבחינתי, באמת שאין לי בית אחר.
You see a fence, and just imagining what it must be like to know that any moment somebody could be crawling through a tunnel. I think it's hard to imagine what that must be like until you see it with your own eyes.
I think it was really interesting to hear the differences of influences in the music. I heard Latin, I heard a lot of jazz, so it's really cool to hear the fusion of music here. Music was a key medium for messaging, and you know, psychologically people remember things put to music, so music can be used in a pretty powerful way. And some of the largest crowds in the world are not drawn by politicians, they're not drawn by, you know, really great leaders, they're drawn by musicians and artists. And so it's why I love music, because of its power to really change people.
Good afternoon to everyone. First of all, I would like to welcome you to Jerusalem, the city capital of Israel. It was out of the understanding that there is no other place for the Jewish people but to establish a state of Israel.
You feel this connection as a Jewish person to not only the land, but to the people and to the culture, and it's unlike anywhere else in the world.
My sense of attachment to the history of the people has been deep, so I definitely think I'll return to Israel soon.
What was great about this group of people is that you had doctors, you had entrepreneurs, you had people who were in state government, you had people like me who were in federal government, and you just realized that everyone is united in a common cause.
I hate saying goodbye to friends and stuff, but the good thing about saying goodbye sometimes after trips like this is that until you have to say goodbye, you don't really fully internalize and appreciate what good friends you've made.
One, two, three.
It's been a great trip. Really a life-changing experience. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right.